Welcome to my YouTube channel. It's been a long time and today we're gonna talk about the accessory sex gland in males. In my previous video, we have already talked about the male sex glands and we have also talked about the hormonal regulation. In this video, we will know more about what the accessory sex glands are, what their functions are, and how they help in the overall process. So, without wasting more time, let's dive in. There are mainly three types of accessory sex glands. The first one is the seminal vesicle. The second one is the prostate gland. And the third one, we have the bulbourethral gland. So these are the three types of glands that are present, and together they are known as the accessory sex glands. The bulbourethral glands are present in two, so they are a pair. While the prostate gland is present as one, and the seminal vesicle is also one. So the bulbourethral gland is two in number, while the others are one each. Then the seminal vesicles secrete the alkaline fluid and makes up about the 60% of the seminal plasma. Its secretions mainly contain fructose, prostaglandins, and mucus. The fructose helps in energizing the sperms, prostaglandins help in the contraction of the female uterine tract and the female vaginal tract, and this contraction helps to move the sperm upward when it is deposited. Mucus helps in lubrication. Now, let's understand what the prostate gland is. So, the prostate gland is a lobulated gland and it lies below the urinary bladder. So, the secretions from the prostate gland is about 30% of the overall seminal plasma. The secretions contains some lipids, some proteins, and some amount of sodium bicarbonate and citric acids. This contains some amount of lipids, proteins. So it is also a little bit alkaline, and the bicarbonates play a major role in that. The lipids and the proteins are useful for the sperm's nutrition and the overall composition of the semen. Process secretion is to increase the mobility of the sperms. Increases the mobility of the sperms. Also provides nutrition. So the prostate gland secretion provides nutrition and also helps to increase the mobility of the sperms in the female tract. Now we will understand the functions of the bulbourethral gland. The bulbourethral glands are also called Cowper's glands. They are a size of the pea, so basically very small, and mainly they secrete alkaline secretions and mucus. The secretions from the bulbourethral glands are the first to go out during stimulation, and they mainly help to neutralize the acids in the urethra of the males. It also has another function, and that is it helps to lubricate the tip of the penis before the other secretion and semen are given out. So this basically wraps up the accessory sex glands, their functions, and the overall role of the accessory sex glands in male reproduction. So let's have a small recap of what we just learned. Seminal vesicles are the most important gland. They secrete fructose and prostaglandins. It is mainly for nutrition and contraction of the vaginal space. The prostate gland secretions mainly contain some amount of lipids, proteins, citric acid, and some amount of bicarbonates. This helps to increase the mobility of the sperms and also helps them to nourish. Lastly, we have the Cowper's glands. The Cowper's glands mainly help to neutralize the uric acids present in the urethra of the males. And lastly, they help to lubricate the tips of the penis and the urethra before ejaculation. I will end this video, and till the next video comes, I'll say a goodbye.